friends, my name is Umesh, Arya, and I'm a teacher of media studies. This video will focus on the browser extensions for enhanced digital skills. So it simply means that we are talking about some special small tiny softwares which are attached to the main browser window, and they will enhance our digital learning skill. So hardly a day passes when we don't read the creative inventions and applications which have been developed by the technologists for improving our work, productivity, ease of doing business, communicating far and wide, improvement in teaching and learning, etc. This list is actually endless. So let's focus on the most important part of the computer software, that's known as the web browser, which acts as our portal to the web. In other words, it is our window to the outside world of opportunities floating in the cyberspace. Yeah. Most of us are familiar with Google Chrome and Firefox. These are two most popular web browsers to surf the internet. Let's define the browser in a scientific way. So a web browser is defined as a native application program running on the client machine of www. It accepts command from the users and it gets the information from the world wide web according to the user's commands and displays the information for the user. So this we all know, we are very familiar with the browser world. Coming on to the extension part of it, as I just explained, extensions are very small tiny pieces of the software, and they occupy the space on the right side of the browser window and they are activated by clicking on them. So you must have seen a few people using the main browser window, and on the browser window on the right side there will be some icons. The icons are the extensions, meaning thereby that that's for example dark theme is the name of the extension. Then it means if you will activate that extension by clicking on the icon, then the web page will become dark. I mean the white part of the web page will become dark and the letters will be in the black so that your eyes are not affected. So this was just a small example of the extensions, and the picture is very large. Some of these extensions may direct you to the parent website or the server where most of them perform the action on the spot. However, a few of them are constantly in touch with their website and may send data regularly regarding the browsing history and habits of the internet user. So all kind of possibilities are there. The extension is stand alone also. It is simultaneously in it is in sync with the server, and some of the extensions they are displayed here, but when you click them then a website is opened and you can get the benefit by visiting the website. So that's three or four kind of operating types are there. So extensions provide a short explanation to the art of accomplishing the work directly on the browser without visiting the different websites. It reduces the information overload because as we all know, we are currently victims of the information overload. So many of the information is coming to us from all the sites: social media, WhatsApp, Twitter, Facebook, emails, SMSs. So many of the information, we are not able to make sense of this information. So the extensions, they make your work easier. You don't have to visit the different websites for that, and there are tiny pieces in the form of extensions on your main browser. That's the key part of it. We'll discuss the different browsers one by one, and a few of the browser extensions I have covered in my earlier topics also, but I'll cover this more here in this module. So first of all is link clump, L-I-N-K, link clump, C-L-U-M-P. This is a very good browser extension for harvesting the headlines and the URL of the links inside a web page. It is mostly used to scrape the search engine results. So link clump enables you to drag a determination box around, and it utilizes the mouse function to immediately open the new tabs, and in the new window it can harvest the bookmarks and copy them onto the clipboard, where you can go to any word processor program like Excel and you can paste them, and the things would be there. And the listing would be like, first column will be having the headlines of the web page, and the second column would be having the hyperlinks of that web page. Second is the scraper. Scraper is also a very good browser extension, and it's a very simple data mining extension for facilitating online research. When you need to go to when you need to get data into spreadsheet very quickly. So it is intended as an easy to use tool. This extension allows you to download the data from an HTML web page, and it has two options. First one is the scraper, and the second one is the scrape similar. Scraper function is slightly technical, but scrape similar function is very easy. Once you visit the web store and install the scraper extension, and you click anywhere in the text of the web page, right click, and then you will get two options, scrape similar, and it will scrape the similar text and it will open along the side of the window where you can copy and paste in order to paste into the word processing software. Next one is the multi highlight. This extension allows you to highlight the multiple words inside a web page, and it is assumed that all the historical data and newly created data have found its way on the web, and the web is a standard repository of information. Once it is established, then we want to conquer that information by highlighting different words in the web page, and we can focus, we can pinpoint our inquiry on more than 2-3 words. So simultaneously you are dealing with so many information. So this is possible through this multi-highlight extension. Another one is Invid, INVID, and REVI, REVEIE. So these two extensions, they are very good for the data verifiers and fake news busters. So this extension is provided by Invid European project to help journalists and fact checkers to verify content on social networks. It basically deals with the fake news propagation on the social networks, and as a responsible citizen, we must bust those fake news. And it has been designed as a verification Swiss Army knife, helping journalists to save time and be more efficient in their fact-checking and debunking tasks on the social networks, especially when you are verifying the videos and the images. So what happens that these extensions, they sit on the browser, and once you find a suspicious photograph on the internet, then you just right click that photograph, and on the right click there will be Invid and REVI functionalities available. If you click REVI, then it will refer to the image websites on which this image may be available, or any more form, distorted form of this image may be available, and you can go and check yourself. That's more important. Then we come to the CrowdTangle browser extension. The summary on the extension page mentions the following about this service. The following means that in a nutshell, let me explain you this way. You are visiting any Facebook page, you are visiting any link on the website, and you assume that this link is shared by the people, but you don't know how much it is shared and how much it has been forwarded by other people. So there are many variables of that. So CrowdTangle, once you download that, it will sit on the browser and it will monitor that data for you. It's an easy way to see how often a link has been shared, who shared it and what they said. And CrowdTangle shows the specific web posts, Instagram posts, tweets and subreddits that mention this link, meaning thereby the viral nature of any link is determined by the CrowdTangle. And because same kind of link has been posted at multiple websites, multiple social networking websites, and this way we can find out the reach of the fake news. So it works for the articles as well as YouTube videos, Facebook videos and many more. In a nutshell, any kind of link you can track it on CrowdTangle for its viral ability. This extension is a must for the fact checkers, actually, social media researchers, political analysts and social researchers, along with data verifiers. Yeah. So the rationale behind the service is that assumption that people are sharing and discussing the links, issues and engaging with them in an active way. The data is downloadable in the CSV format in CrowdTangle, and it can be analyzed as per the research objectives and your point of query. The next one is the Science Research Assistant. This is the name of the extension, and this program allows the researchers and the writers to search for a particular word, and many research publications, lot many databases, Google books, lot many search engines will be simultaneously search for that particular word. So you don't have to go to the different websites again and again and enter and then bring out the result. No, it will not collect the result, it will not collate the results, but Science Research Assistant simply opens the different windows of different publications so that you save your time and you don't have to remember all those websites yourself. Then is your Rabbi reverse image search. I just explained this is an era of fake news and unverified information. According to the BBC server in India, finds maximum news are spread through the photos, right? And academicians and researchers unintentionally forward the unverified information downloaded from internet, and sometimes they have to face the music for that. So to verify that image, just Rabbi extension searches the centered image in the Google, Bing, Yahoo, Baidu, TinEye and Yandex. So it searches so many, around 6 search engines for that particular image. So Rabbi search image, reverse search image is also very good extension, though I have discussed this just before, but that was in the combination of the invite. And then we come to the table capture extension. As far as scraping is concerned, the scraping part is mainly it mainly deals with the data, meaning thereby text download. But here we are talking about the table. I'm talking about the text inside the table. So it is not easy to harvest the table because the dimensions and the HTML tags of the table, they are different. But this table capture extensions gives you the facility to capture easily the tables inside the HTML format for analysis in the spreadsheet just by using multiple softwares like Microsoft Excel, Microsoft 365, OpenOffice, Google Sheets, all put together. The extension icon activates automatically when it detects any table on the particular web page. You don't have to do anything, just visit a page which has got different tables, and when you click on the icon of this extension, then automatically a window pops up which explains the occurrence of the tables on that particular page, and you select that table and it will be harvested for you, and it will be copied onto the clipboard, or directly it can be downloaded in the CSV format or any other format. The one very good extension is the Google Scholar. Now Google Scholar, it is already known to the academicians as a very, very efficient free research publication software. So we have to go to the Google Scholar, scholar.google.com, and enter the query every time to get the results. But here, for example, we are going through a research publication. At the end of the research publication, there are references, and we highlight the we select the title of the publication and click Google Scholar for that. There's an extension that on the right side in a small window, it will bring all the publications related to that, and simultaneously the citation can be generated from there and then. So you just need to select the title of the page you are reading and click the extension icon. One very good is Grammarly. You will get recommendations from Grammarly as you write on Gmail, Twitter, LinkedIn, and about wherever else you will find the composing need. If you are writing something even on Gmail, social networks, and all that, so Grammarly works behind the curtain. It will highlight the wrong word, it will highlight the spelling correction need, and it will suggest few sentence correction based on the theme, based on the sentiment, based on the current mood of the sentence. So Grammarly uses some artificial intelligence applications to find out the different treatment with the text you are writing. So it's very good, and it's Grammarly can be called as a composing colleague that goes further than language structure to offer you far-reaching composing inputs. And it can detect the tone of the sentence that is hard, soft, and natural, and convey the meaning in a subconscious way, and you can correct them or alter them if the need be. Then is Evernote Web Clipper. I think it's one of the most widely used and used for quite some time than other extensions. Evernote, it is a leader in the clipping and saving for the for further use. Whether you see any web page or any other thing, the story goes like this: that you are visiting a web page and you find a particular paragraph or the sentence in the web page very interesting. So you just select that particular paragraph and click Evernote. It will save the address of the web page. It will save the web page as such and highlight the para which is being selected by you. That so that if you visit the Evernote website and open your account, then this web page is saved as such, and you don't have to worry about the citation, don't have to worry about again finding the same page on the web. So all that it is taken care for you. So Evernote Web Clipper encourages you to use fascinating things you find on the web, and it saves in the Evernote account. Yeah, with Evernote Web Clipper you can clip any website, any web page, any image, any still shot of any moving video, and highlight what you like most about it, and you can use tags also, and all these information is searchable, meaning thereby if you have clipped too much, if you have saved too much of the web links, then you can search between those web links which are having some particular word or the particular information. And then is Screencastify. Humans, they are basically visual learners, especially when the learning is action-based, in contrast to the theory. So you must have seen that text doesn't normally evoke much interest as that of the video. So Screencastify is a very simple and non-technical way to prepare your own video tutorials, and these are hassle-free. The process is very simple, and presenter can choose three options. It's a full screen or just the desktop, browser, and the webcam. I should say these are only three options. First is full screen desktop, in which you select full screen, then whatever happens behind that screen will be captured by the Screencastify. This is one. If you select that browser option, then it will record only the activities inside that particular browser. And then is the webcam, means you can record your own video on the webcam as you are currently watching right now. So this is a very known technical way. You just download this and you know, it get pasted to the browser, and then you start it, and then just press next, and it will ask you different permissions you will be happy to give, and then it will start as 3, 2, 1 start, and you start speaking. It will, there will be a webcam alongside, and you can reposition the position of the webcam photo inside the recording. Like these things can be done anytime, and once you are done, just click stop and the file would be ready with the MP4 format. You can download this, you can share this, you can do whatever you want. Yeah. So friends, these were a few extensions which I discussed, and these are very good extensions, and you can use them free of cost, no money involved, and they will make your teaching and learning a really fun-laden experience. Thank you so much.